Welcome to AETCM, the Emergency Medicine Channel. Today we are going to discuss about jaundice. Okay, you may be knowing jaundice means yellowish discoloration. You can see all over the body, skin is yellow, sclera is yellow. This is because an elevation in a component called as bilirubin. We'll see how bilirubin is produced, then you'll understand the etiopathology behind jaundice. This is your blood vessel. This is RBC in that. Normally, when the RBC become old, it will break down into heme and globin. The heme again, it will be converted to bilirubin and bilirubin. So we'll see hemoglobin. From hemoglobin, bilirubin is produced. This bilirubin is tightly bound with albumin. You see, this is your kidney. So when it is bound with albumin, it cannot pass through the kidney. So it will come back to the circulation itself. Then it will go to the liver. You can see here, the bilirubin which is unconjugated will go to the liver, and by an enzyme called as glucuronyl conjugate, this bilirubin which is unconjugated will become conjugated bilirubin. So here it is conjugated bilirubin. From liver, it will go through the bile duct. There you can see gallbladder will be there, pancreas will be there, and intestine will be there. This bilirubin will be secreted to intestine. Through the stools, it will go to through the stool it will go down. This is called a streptobilirubin. So if you see the normal clinical pattern, RBCs will be broken down to bilirubin, bilirubin. That bilirubin is unconjugated, it is conjugated inside the liver, then it will go to the intestine, that gives yellow color for stools. Normal process, it will not go through the kidney because it is tightly bound with albumin. But if the bilirubin in the conjugated bilirubin increases, it is not bound with albumin, it can go through the kidneys. So we'll see what happens in a patient who is having jaundice, how clinically you will detect whether what is the reason for jaundice. Okay. Now you see, if there is a problem in the blood vessel or in the RBCs which is broken down, RBC is excessively broken down, this is called as hemolysis. If there is a condition which can produce excessive breaking down of RBCs, that is called as hemolysis, that can elevate indirect bilirubin. Since it is bound with albumin, it will not go through the kidney, so you don't get a yellow urine. Okay, so excessive breaking down of RBCs can be seen in hemolysis. Hemolysis can be due to a problem in the RBC membrane, a problem in the enzymes in the RBCs, a problem inside the RBC. So there are multiple reasons for hemolysis. It can be enzymopathies or hemoglobinopathies, or it can be due to a membranopathies. There are multiple reasons for that. We will not discuss that. But whatever it may be, if there is a destruction of RBC, this is called as hemolysis. It can be due to congenital disease or an acquired disease like sepsis, malaria, which can destroy RBC, a large spleen can destroy RBCs. Whatever may be the reason, if the number of RBCs are destructed more than normal, you can get a increased indirect hyperbilirubinemia. So if you are doing a liver function test, you know that there is direct bilirubin and indirect bilirubin. In a hemolysis, you can see indirect bilirubin will be normal. Normal bilirubin is 1 milligram per deciliter. If it is more than 3, you call it as clinical jaundice. So indirect bilirubinemia, you can see up to 4, you can see elevation of bilirubin. Some conditions it may be elevated. So indirect bilirubin is elevated in hemolysis. Some more investigation, if you see, LDH will be elevated, peripheral smear may show evidence of hemolysis, all these things can be there. So bilirubin is elevated, indirect bilirubin is elevated, direct bilirubin is normal, liver enzymes also normal, SGOT, SGPT both will be normal. Now you come down, if there is a problem in the liver, for example we take hepatitis, okay, viral hepatitis, hepatitis B, C, A or D, all these things can produce damage in the liver. The conversion may be reduced, but sometimes what happens after conversion only, there will be a problem inside the liver. So that will elevate the conjugated bilirubin. So here unconjugated bilirubin also will be elevated, but it is predominantly conjugated bilirubin. Whenever there is a liver problem, you get a jaundice, but conjugated bilirubin is predominantly elevated. You can even get an elevation of indirect bilirubin, but this is more than this. So conjugated bilirubin elevation is more than indirected bilirubinemia. But if you see the SGOT-SGPT, that is liver enzyme SGOT-SGPT, that also will be elevated because liver is damaged. Like in hepatitis, liver is damaged. So SGOT-SGPT will also be elevated. What happens to this bilirubin? When it increases in your blood, it is not bound with albumin. It can go to the kidney and it can go out. Okay. So what will be the color of urine? Color of urine in a direct hyperbilirubinemia will be yellow because it is going through the kidneys. Okay. So how do you diagnose an indirect hyperbilirubinemia from a liver-induced hyperbilirubinemia? Very, very simple. Patient will have clinical jaundice. Urine is normal color. But whereas the liver problem, patient will have more jaundice than this one because the bilirubin may be 10, 15, 20 like that. It is elevated. Liver enzymes are elevated. Urine shows bilirubin. Urine will have a darker color. Okay. So, two important things. Now, we'll see other parts of the liver function test. You see the albumin globulin. Okay. Normally, albumin is always more than globulin. If a liver disease which is chronic, like a chronic hepatitis, chronic alcoholic liver disease, globulin will be more than albumin. So somebody is having jaundice, SGOT-SGPT is mildly elevated, albumin is lower than globulin, you have to suspect a chronic liver disease. Okay. So you understood how to make a clinical diagnosis of pre-hepatic jaundice or hemolytic jaundice. Mild jaundice, no urine color. Okay, normal urine color. More severe jaundice here, SGOT-SGPT is elevated. If it is chronic, albumin is low. Then if you see the urine, it is darker yellow. Okay. Now you come down after liver, post-hepatic jaundice. That means obstructive jaundice. There is a biliary tract here. Somewhere here there is a tract, common bile duct, gallbladder. If there is a block here, we'll see what happened. Okay. This is called as post-hepatic jaundice or obstructive jaundice. Okay. So this is hemolytic jaundice, hepatic jaundice, post-hepatic or obstructive jaundice. This can be due to a stone, stricture, malignancy, some parasite. So many causes can produce an obstructive jaundice. We'll see what will be the clinical feature. So indirect bilirubin converted to direct bilirubin, gone out from the liver. There is no problem in the liver. Then there is a problem here. So bilirubin will accumulate here. It will go to the blood and the level of bilirubin will be larger than a liver problem. So you get a very, very high jaundice. Patient will be deeply jaundiced and patient can have severe itching because of the high elevation of bilirubin. Patient can have bradycardia because of high elevation of bilirubin. All these things are clinical feature. But when you investigate what happened to liver enzymes, there is no problem for the liver, there is no hemolysis, so you don't get an LDH elevation, you don't get peripheral smear problem, you don't get an SGOT-SGPT elevation like liver disease, albumin globulin may be normal. And if you see the urine, previously the first one was hemolytic jaundice, no urine color. Then you get more yellow color in the urine in liver disease. But in obstructive jaundice, you get severe discoloration. So severe yellowish discoloration of urine is classically seen in obstructive jaundice. Okay. Now the last part is, whenever a normal biliary tract is there, bilirubin will go to the stool and it will give a golden yellow color for the stool. If there is a block here, bilirubin will not come to the intestine, it will not give the color. So the stool will not have normal color, you get a clay colored urine. Okay. So that is one important clinical clue. Very dark urine, deep jaundice, pale or clay colored stool is a classical clinical finding of obstructive jaundice. Patient can have severe itching, bradycardia, normal liver enzymes, normal albumin globulin and high colored urine. And if you see one investigation which is very important, alkaline phosphatase. Alkaline phosphatase is highly elevated in obstructive jaundice, but remember, it can even elevate in an obstructive phase of hepatic jaundice. That means whenever there is an acute hepatitis, you can see the cells in the liver will be swollen. Okay, that may produce some obstruction in the bile canaliculi. It can produce some amount of obstruction. There also you can get alkaline phosphatase elevated, but in a obstructive jaundice, it will be very, very deep. Okay, so we have discussed various type of jaundice. So when you examine the patient's eye, you can see yellow color. You can examine the body, the skin may be yellow. But you should understand what is the reason for jaundice. Prehepatic jaundice, if you see the color, will be lemon yellow, very mild yellow. In a liver disease, it will be deeper yellow. But in an obstructive jaundice, it will be very, very deeper yellow, or it is like orange yellow. Okay, so mild yellow, moderate yellow, severe yellow. Okay, now if you see the urine color, in a prehepatic jaundice, there is no discoloration of urine because bilirubin will never go to the kidney because it is bound with albumin. Whereas if you take the liver problem, it is slightly more discolored, you can see yellow urine. Okay. But if you see the obstructive jaundice, nothing is going out of liver, everything is accumulated in the blood, everything is going through the urine, so it will be severely discolored. Okay, if you see the lab investigation in prehepatic jaundice, patient can have anemia, patient can have jaundice, patient can have elevated indirect hyperbilirubinemia, LDH will be elevated, peripheral smear may show evidence of hemolysis. If you see the liver problem, SGOT, SGPT is very high. Albumin globulin may be ratio may be reversed in a chronic liver disease, but alkaline phosphatase normally it is not elevated, but some condition like acute hepatitis it may be elevated. If you the obstructive phase of jaundice, there is clear colored stool, there is darkly yellow urine, and if you see the alkaline phosphatase, it is very, very high. So we have discussed about the clinical feature of jaundice, various types of jaundice. How to examine is very, very simple. Look at the eyes of the patient, it will be the sclera of the eye will be yellow, skin will be yellow. You can have scratch marks all over the body in obstructive jaundice. Ask about the history of urine color and skin color, stool color. It may give a clue about the type of jaundice. Do some basic investigation. You can make what is the thing. And ultimately, you have to go for an ultrasound scan to know where is the problem in the liver or post-hepatic phase. Thank you. Thank you.